Okay, here we go. Right. Okay, hi guys, and welcome to the show. So, 4 years, it's been 4 years. I can't believe it. Actually, that reminds me, the next couple of videos will be a few specials to mark this special day. God, where do we start? Well, we gotta start with a wristwatch check. So I'm wearing my Nakin today for a very specific reason, which I'll get into in just a moment. So that is my wristwatch check. But before I forget, I've gotta do a quick couple of thank yous. First and foremost, I gotta thank every one of you out there, the good gentry, you guys that watch, everybody that comments, everybody that supports the channel it in any shape or form. It doesn't matter, just by watching and the feedback and the emails, and I'm just so sorry that I can't reply to all of you. I spend literally several hours a day replying to as many of you as I can. It's just getting to a point where it's really difficult, but yeah, just keep watching and thank you so much, guys. I'm so happy to do what I love. Still only part-time, but you know, at the end of the day, watches is a very niche subject. I know my channel is minute in the whole YouTube cosmos, but I'm humbled by the encouragement and just the positivity. So much positivity. You guys inspire me. Oh, and by the way, guys, I was gonna wear the lion's shark today. Don't laugh. But it's in the bank. I keep my lion's shark in the bank because it's so special to me. But yeah, I gotta wear it more. I baby it. I know. I'm a hypocrite. I tell you guys to wear your watches, but you understand how important that watch is to me. But anyway, massive thank you to Giancarlo, to GCR. I don't think you guys realize how integral he is in the last 2 years I've known him. He's become a really good friend, mio fratello. He got us to Switzerland. He opened so many doors. I can't thank him enough. And do follow him on Instagram, Gentiloggio. It's a mix of, because orologio in Italian is watch and gentleman, obviously, so he merged it together. Very smart guy. I love that name. I almost wish I came up with that. He is on Instagram, so do follow him. I'll leave a link down below. But he really should be called Putana Loggio, because he is the biggest watch slut. I mean, I thought I was bad. He's even worse. But, you know, c'è sempre una puttana più grande di te, you know? Big thank you to Joe Bananas for the support. My good friend Joe Bananas. Vito, of course, he runs behind the camera is basically the store, where we run the website and... You can't see it, it's not very glamorous, but it's just boxes and boxes of NATO straps. Yeah, literally. So, yeah, thank you to Vito for his meticulous attention to detail. Who else? David, who runs the website. I'm looking at this because I'm terrible with names, I forget everybody. My good friend Richard at Saltzman's for all the advice. Mark at Long Island Watches. John Keel at Watch Gauge. Who else we got? Sophie Furley, of course, who very generously interviewed me. I was in Revolution magazine, I think it was last month. I'm still waiting for my copy. Everybody back home in England is waiting for their copy so they can frame it. And shout out obviously to my family in the UK and in Italy, because I have family, my family here, my family in the United States, Italy and England, they all watch. And Scotland as well, so actually I have family all over the place. Un bacione a tutti. The admins, of course, the Facebook crew, we've got Justin, Jeremy, Matthew, Sacramento, Bill, Noel. Did I say Jeremy? I think I said Jeremy. Chad has just joined us, Marco, Ricardo, of course. I can't forget Ricardo with that lovely new Tudor. Very, very nice indeed. Last, but by no means least, to Peter Golden. He wrote this, where's the card? Hold on a second. So he wrote, Dear TGV, it was while watching your show and looking at your group on Facebook that I decided to add a Rolex GMT and an Explorer to this novel that he's a writer. I've only just got this, so I've only just started it, but from what I've read so far, he is a fantastic writer. I'm very much looking forward to finishing this. And so kindly, he's put me in the acknowledgements at the back of the book. I've never been published in a book. My name is in a... It's crazy, right? I mean, who would have imagined it just from doing an Oris review and talking about some arty films that, you know, back in the day I would be 4 years later. And anyway, thank you so much, Peter. That really made my day made my entire month, to be honest. Oh, and I think I'm going to add it to my new Amazon shop. I have finally started an affiliate program. All the big YouTubers do it. I don't know why it's taking me years to do it. But a lot of the stuff you see behind me in the war room, you can now buy on Amazon, and a tiny percentage goes to supporting the channel and keeping the lights on. It literally keeps the lights on. So yeah, there'll be a link to my Amazon store down below. Now let's get into the Urban Gentry watch. To make the first official Urban Gentry watch, because the Lion Shark, that was the TGV watch, right? This is the Urban Gentry watch. That watch, Lion Shark, I designed for myself. I just, you know, if you watch the video, you'll understand why I did things in a certain way. That was designed for me. This is designed for you, so I've kept it simpler with a monochromatic scheme, and I've partnered with NTH. The reason is because, well, first of all, I fell in love with the Nakin. However, I do understand it having a lot of the elements. It's too much of a homage watch for a lot of people, and I totally understand that. I'm fine with it, you know. I get enjoyment out of it. I'm fine with that. But people tend to misunderstand it's a homage to an entire era of military watches. We've got elements of the Rolex with the big crown. We've got the case like the Omega 300 from 1957. We have the snowflake hands from the Tudor. You know, it goes on and on. So it's like a ultra homage in a way. But I was so impressed by the case in particular. It actually broke a record. It was the thinnest. It's 11.5 millimeters thick, and it was the thinnest 300 meter water resistant diver under 12 millimeters to hold that depth rating until it was surpassed, I think, recently by Blancpain. I don't know which Blancpain, but guys, do if you know, do let me know. I met Chris and I got on with him. I really like Chris. He's a military vet, which you could just tell straight away because he's no-nonsense, very methodical. You know, everything is run like a military operation. I really respect that. Coming from a military family, I already get that, you know. So we were talking and I said, you know, we should definitely collaborate one day. And I didn't think much of it, but, and then we just, ideas back and forth, and I sent him some sketches and he said, "Oh, we can do that, but we can't do this, but blah, blah, blah." And guys, when you make a watch, there's a lot of armchair watchmakers out there, right? Who you know, it's very easy to criticize, very easy. But until you've done it and until you know all the details, and especially trying to keep it in budget, because I did want to do an SKX. Do you guys remember? But it ended up costing, if you look at my SKX, right? That costs almost $1,000, all right? And not everybody's gonna pay $1,000 for an SKX. But, you know, I wanted the ceramic bezel, I wanted loom here, I wanted, you know, the more premium movement, I wanted hacking and all the rest of it. I wanted Cerakote. Anyway, That's a different watch. I'll come back to that in another video. I wanted to base my watch on this case. I love this case. It's so slender. It's so comfortable. I wanted no date. I wanted it to be a pilot's watch, but with the characteristics of a diver, because those are my two favorite genres. We all love divers because, well, not we don't all love divers, but we love divers predominantly, those who do, because they have that sense of adventure. They're tough, they're robust. You know, they're just great everyday watches. I also love aviation watches, so I thought, well, let's put it together. This is the first NTH sub that is technically a pilot's watch. So I wanted to keep track of multiple time zones, so I added a 12-hour bezel. I kept the 20-minute increments to do basic timing. So 120-click, unidirectional. I'll go through the specs. Exactly same scale and size as this. This is just the perfect watch. It wears, to be honest, more like a 38 millimeter. It will come on the brushed oyster style bracelet with the double push button deployant, just like your regular Nakin sub or any of the NTH subs. We've got a double domed sapphire anti-reflective coating, two layers applied internally, which is my favorite way of doing it. DLC diamond like carbon coating on the bezel insert, which is brushed, so really, really super robust. And this is a point I insisted with Chris, and this was tough to do, keeping it within budget, but it's loomed. We got a loomed bezel. Not only is the crown loomed, which is something I love, and by the way, I'll share pics of, or images, close-ups of my Nakin, so you'll get a vague idea of what it's gonna be like. On the back, we have we got the new engraved Urban Gentry logo of the lion holding the hourglass. So if you guys have been following me, originally it was my family crest, but because we've grown and the Gentry is not just me, it's you guys, it's everybody that's part of our community, it felt wrong. So we had to, you know, redesign it to encompass all of us. It's symbolic of us, the lion, strength, honor, you know, power, all the cliches, but really it represents you guys now. So now we have the new engraving on the back. I didn't put it on the dial. I thought it would be too much clutter. So it's just very simply a little bit of text. We'll go into the name in just a moment because I think you guys will like it. Inside we get the Miota 9015 automatic. Hacky money wind, all the rest of it. 42-hour power reserve. Well, the case is built around that movement, so it's very thin, rock solid, extremely affordable to maintain, performs like a trooper, I love that movement. So the aesthetics of the watch are very kind of international. We have the dial is a nod to Germany with the Flieger Type A dial. We've slightly kind of changed the proportions to fit the watch a bit better. So it's matte with the crisp, all fully loomed, all the numerals are loomed, everything's loomed. Then we have British MOD spec hands. The crown obviously is very kind of 1954 Rolex Submariner inspired. The case with that beautiful beveling is also rather Seamaster-esque. You could almost say Rolex Oyster-ish a little bit. Chris actually says that the case was inspired by the Rolex 6538, which is a military issued combat diver. But you know, it's very much up for interpretation. So it's got that international flair, you know, the Japanese movement, the German dial, the Swiss design cues in the case, and this, that, and the other. I'm sure I missed out a lot of things. I'll leave a link. It will be on sale through Watch Gauge, where I bought my Nakin. I had to go with John Keel. I was so impressed with the service I received from him. I've interviewed him. He's also become a really good friend and a kind of a bit of a mentor for me, really, to be honest, because he comes from the super high-end part of the watch industry, super luxury. He started his Watch Gauge because he has a passion for micro brands, which I really respect. You know, I really respect his knowledge, and he just knows everybody. You ask anybody in the industry, if if John doesn't know them or vice versa, then yeah, they're not in the watch industry, you know? I had to go with him as the distributor, which is fantastic because I never want to sell watches. That's not what I'm about. I feel it would kind of undermine it would undermine the integrity of the channel, really. I mean, if you notice, when I did my squale, I didn't call it a review, it was a presentation. In fact, when I get the Catalina, which I'll get onto the naming in just a moment, I will probably pass it to another channel to review, and then it can be completely unbiased, you know? Because obviously I'm gonna love it, you know? It's just the perfect setup, because also I don't have the time. The last thing I ever want to do is be a watch dealer, and I've said this many, many times. The name, well, it's named after the PBY Catalina, which is this incredible 1930s. I think it was originally first flew in 1935, but it was produced from 1936 to 1945, the end of the war. But it remained in civilian use. Brazil still uses them, Sweden, many countries actually, and the United States Army and the Air Force used them all the way up to the 80s, believe it or not. It's a majestic beast of a plane. It's basically a flying boat, and hence, you know, you guys know I'm absolutely obsessed with the propeller age. There's just some kind of charm, there's a romance about these beautiful shapes, you know. I just that age of exploration, you know, pre-jet especially just intrigues me. I don't know why, but anyway. And I love World War II history, and a lot of the style cues are like dial and stuff. It's also a Latin name, so it was just a natural. We named it the Catalina. It just, everybody was like, yeah, that's what we should call it. It's a hybrid. It's like the plane. It's a dive watch, also a pilot's watch. Why not? You know, why not have the best of both worlds? The Catalina was used by the British Royal Air Force, by the Canadian Air Force, the American Air Force, Navy. Who else? The Australian Air Force as well. It was originally intended as a bomber, but then they used it for hunting submarines, mainly for patrolling in the war. But the design of it is so, I mean, the underneath of it, it looks like the bow of it, I mean, it looks like a boat, but then on the top it's a ruddy great big plane with these huge engines mounted on the top. I love the 1930s as well, so it had to be. Oh, I just remembered one interesting fact. Jacques Cousteau actually used a Catalina in his diving expedition, one of his expeditions. I didn't know this. This is a fact that Chris actually pointed out, which is really, really cool. So kind of in keeping with the whole dive watch thing. Very, very cool. Anyway, that is it. Now, I did buy a watch to commemorate for my anniversary. I will save that to next week. I'll do the unboxing next week. A couple more videos to mark the occasion, so stay tuned. But anyway, guys, I'm rabbiting on. I'm extremely tired. I had to re-record this video because it was so hot today, and with the blaring lights in here and the heat, and no air conditioning was for some reason. I'm in Lacoste. It's Lacoste time, finally. So I'm re-recording this, and I'm really, really hot. I need some more water. So I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. Oh, I should mention, by the way, guys, this is a pre-order. There'll be a link down below. The more people pre-order now, the more we'll make. So this is a special edition, not a limited edition. So if we get 100 pre-orders, we'll make 150. If we get 200, we'll make 300, etc. However, if you want one this year, you've got to pre-order in the next 30 days. I believe the price is $650, including shipping. I have to double check on, I'm pretty sure John does international. I have to check, but check in the link below. I'll double check myself. I can't wait. Please do order one. Please do consider it. You have to order in the next 30 days. Even if I'm the only one that orders it, I'm excited. I really honestly don't care. I just want to wear the watch, you know? So that's it. So, Yeah, thank you so much again for another amazing year. I don't even know what are we at? We've surpassed 200,000 subscribers. I mean, still very niche and small for YouTube, but yeah, hopefully we can. Yeah, I don't really care about that, to be honest. Don't know why I'm even talking about it. Okay, guys, I'm gonna leave it there. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, found it useful, and as always, onwards and upwards, and I'll catch you in the next one. Okay, guys, ciao.